Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijja, a retired lecturer of metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to give you deliberation on the explaining the marriage of the sun. And I'm trying to explain it as in detail as possible. But any question you have, you can always ask me and we can share. So our father, as I said, does not speak, but our mother, Holy Spirit, does to feed us the living bread. So, as I said, Jesus represented both our Father when he was performing merciful deeds or a philanthropic work, and he also represented our mother, Holy Spirit, as the Anointed Daughter with capital D when he was preaching gospel. Same we, unless we have Christ in our heart, we cannot preach gospel, because it is only the men of spirit they can understand. And those people have Christ in their heart, they are solitary, and being masters of their own destiny, they are male. Whether in flesh, they are female. That's why St. Thomas says, unless a female becomes a male. Female means those who, people who are under the domination of Pope, Bishop or other people. They do what they are told to do. They are not independent thinker. So they are female. So when you have become an independent thinker, like in John 4, the born blind person, then you become a male. You have Christ in your heart. When you have Christ in your heart, then Holy Spirit rests with you and you have to exercise it. More you use Holy Spirit, more new wine you brew. So the more you get intoxicated with this new wine. So you should try to preach gospel as some of our brethren are doing. But there are very few people who are, because these laborers, we are laborers, we are not disciples, because the laborers and co-workers are very few. It is by the grace of our Father become a laborer. That is why on the baptism of Jesus by John the Baptist, remember Jesus was baptized in the name of second anointed Adam, our mother Holy Spirit proclaimed on behalf of our Father that he, that means Christ Jesus, is my beloved Son, that people should listen to him, that they have come to deliver the gospel. Gospel is delivered like a sower. You remember the parable of the sower? Some seed fell on flat ground, rocky soil, and all that, you know. So gospel is preached like a sower, and those who are lucky, those who have the grace of our Father, they understand it. Gospel is not for everyone. As these dog-collared people will say, gospel is for everyone. So make everyone happy. So they don't need to take trouble to understand what is written and what is underneath, you know. That's why they are called parables, hidden meanings. And the baptism of John was for those who proclaimed their tribal father openly. You know, the people, unless they are sons of man, they cannot be sons of God. And those people who openly declared their tribal fathers. You know, a Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self. So the tribal fathers is the one that represent our self in Adam. The Jew does not come in the line of Adam. Jew, Sikh, Hindu, Muslim, they all come in the line of God. So unless you are son of man, you cannot be son of God. And that's why those people who had openly openly declared their tribal identity. They were called the salt of the earth because they were the salt of the noble man, Adam or Abraham. Abraham was a noble man. So if you become a Jew of physical self, then you break your covenant with Abraham, you become unfaithful to him. I will explain it later. That is for those who knew that Jew is a spiritual self and not the physical self, that the temple priests were making the people of. You remember the people in the temple priest, they were making the people Jew of the physical self. And when they're making people of Jew of the physical self, then they were breaking their covenant with Abraham. Because Abraham was not a Jew of physical self, but he was Semite. So they were making them unfaithful to Abraham. That means saltless people, fanatic. And that's why John the Baptist addressed them as the brood of vipers. He never baptized them. And Christ Jesus had to take a virgin birth among the people of the Judah tribe, for they had become Jews of the physical self, becoming unfaithful to Abraham. So now they are bundled up for final burning in Israel. Such Jews of the physical self are the sons of Satan, the tares. You know the tares, Matthew 13:24-30, tares and wheat plants, that are bundled up now in Israel for final burning, expected to be in 2012. 2012 is the time when the Mayan calendar touches zero. Mayan calendar counts, keeps the record of the spiritual age because it's going negative all the time. Our physical age, as it increases, it goes on becoming positive, you know. You are 30 years old, next year you will be 31, and so. But our spiritual age, when we come into this world, it has been given, oh, you have to live, say, 90 years in this world. And as your physical age increases, then the spiritual age decreases. And when the spiritual age approaches zero, or when you approach the age of 90, that was your spiritual age, then you die. So this age, which is dark age, could be best, you know, judged by this Mayan calendar, which is going negative. And when it touches zero, then we have atomic bombs. Destruction, total destruction. But before this, you know, these people, aggressors, USA and UK, they will attack another country making atomic bomb. And that is expected end of this year, December. So when that happens, then you have real tribulation in the world. People will be fighting. So many things will happen, you will be quite surprised. People have been misguided so far, so many ages, so many centuries they have been misguided. Remember Christ Jesus, Christianity, you know, became corrupt by the end of the first century, never mind the going into the first, when these messianic Jews, they pushed the apostles out of their churches. That was the beginning of darkness. Light came among his own, and his own loved darkness. So these people of Judah tribe, the light came among them, and they loved darkness. And one Judah Iscariot, he could not be trusted. So they loved money. So in this age, is coming to the end very soon.